Kirsty Flynn was selected the Midlands Rose. Kirsty grew up in England but holidayed in Ireland. Her Longford-born parents were keen supporters of the Rose of Tralee. They brought their 9 children to the Midlands Rose selection every year.
You know, when we first moved to England, we were walking down to the rugby club and some local children stopped us and said, "Do you live? Are you from the orphanage on the corner?" And we went, "Where's the orphanage?" And they pointed at our house, because of course it was so unusual to have had a family move in with so many children, and at the time there were only 7. You know, growing up in the UK, we were constantly reminded of our Irishness, and yet bizarrely, when we went back to Longford to sort of have all our teenage years there, we were known as the English girls. So there was this constant battle. We're going, "But we're not English, we're Irish." The reason why I decided to enter the Rose of Tralee is that my parents had been going to the Midlands Rose of Tralee Ball just as a social event every year from the early 80s. So I think I was 15 the first time I went to it. We had a great night out. It was always a fantastic to 600 people, black tie, we got dressed up, you know, 16, 17, wearing cocktail dresses. It was wonderful. And lots of the people used to say to my father in particular, "Brendan, you have 5 daughters here, you know, you must enter one of them one of these days." And my sisters and I just go, "Never in a million years would we ever enter this competition," because it was just too embarrassing to stand up on stage, stretch yourself. We just thought no. Then, after I graduated university, it was 1992, we were in the depths of recession, no one had jobs. So I managed to get a job that earned a bit of money, so I went travelling with my best friend in Brazil. And my mother rang me and said, "When do you think you'll be home?" And I thought, "No, I don't know, you know, whenever the money runs out." And she said, "Well, it's just we've entered you for the Rose of Tralee." And I said, "No way, it's not going to happen." So we hung up. And I thought about it overnight, and I thought, when I do eventually go back, I have no idea what I'm going to do. And then I thought to myself, the Rose of Tralee is actually very well sponsored, and there are a lot of corporate connections. So perhaps I could use it as a platform to announce on the microphone, "I've just graduated, I've got a couple of languages, I'm looking for a job." So I purely used it as a platform.
In the summer of 1993, Kirsty made the journey to Tralee. She was determined to launch her career live on television, but she never considered being crowned.
There were so many amazing girls. There were a few in particular who everyone just thought, "They're absolutely going to be, it's either going to be her, it's going to be her, it's going to be her." You know, and not for one single second did I ever think I'd ever have a chance of playing. To me, it was just, I'm going to make the most of every single second I have here.
Kirsty may have had her doubts about winning, but she was the bookies' favourite from day one.
I came up actually back to Midland, UK. That's the reason I came up. I was in the dome this morning and she looks beautiful. But the problem was, she was gone from 12s to 3s, so she's not value for money at the moment.
So the pressure to perform was on for all the girls.
Now we have a 23-year-old secretary who is our Midlands UK Rose, Midlands UK. Her name is Kirsty Flynn. Say hello to Kirsty.
The dress I wore, you know, I thought it was lovely at the time, and I look back and everyone who sees it just bursts out laughing at the fashion. Whilst it was 1993, I don't think I had quite left the 80s behind.
How long have you been living in the Midlands?
14 years.
14 years. You have no Brum accent or anything.
Well, I don't know about that. You're not going to make me do it, Gary.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Do the Brum accent for me. Go on. It's a lovely accent.
I can't do that. What are they going to say over in there? They're all watching out in Birmingham and Wolverhampton. What are they going to think of me, Guy?
That's a good Brum accent.
No, I can't do that.
I remember having almost an out-of-body experience chatting to Gabriel and looking out, and I thought, why am I not nervous? I'm talking on live television and I'm not nervous in the slightest. However, under my big 1980s style Snow White dress, my knees were knocking.
What about, tell us an idea of your ideal man.
My ideal man?
Yes, your ideal man.
No,
it was only when I stepped off the stage that almost the reality of what I had just done hit. And there was this lovely little lady, I'm not sure if she's still there, and she used to come out and give all the girls a cup of tea. And I have shaky hands at the best of times, and she just handed me this cup of tea, and I literally was going, and I said, do you know what, I'll have it in a little while, I'll just give it back to you there. And I couldn't stop shaking for about 10 minutes. I remember so well, you know, saying to all the girls, because I didn't think for a second I'd win, we were sitting having sandwiches before the final show, and I turned and I said, guys, right, whoever wins, just don't cry, because it looks ridiculous. It looks like the Miss World, and all the tears. I said, just don't do it. Whoever you are, don't cry. And I remember when they called out my name, floods.
1993, International Rose of Tralee, Midlands UK Rose.
They plonked this tiara on my head, which was wonky like this. And then my father came up and he enveloped me in this huge bear hug. And as he did so, he tilted the tiara. I had the vase and the flowers and the tiara going. I was like, oh. But a magical, magical, magical moment. It was wonderful. The irony of the whole event is that after having being given the title of the Rose of Tralee, I was then still looking for my so-called proper job. And I found I was being called in for interview